Folks, welcome to the Hot Box Show. Our guest this evening is Al.
Just Al.
The beep beep face that Charles Lankoyola on Facebook, and also known from GT Hydro. And as always, we're going to be talking
Lank Dank.
Guys,
you're not the troll from GT Hydro, are you?
Am I?
Jesus, you shouldn't have told me.
He puts the troll in GT.
You know what I mean? You know what?
Tito and Boeni follows our Instagram page.
What, GT Hydro?
Get the fuck out of there.
There we go. There we go. That's more convincing to us.
That's trolling in action.
There we go.
Trolling helps.
So you can help us get him on the show.
Message him. We'll see.
And then we're going to go a little feed Twinner Stallone with Alia, talk cannabis controversies, because we live in an echo chamber and it's all singing to the choir. But maybe stoners and the culture is in one dimensional, I hope.
My takeaway from it was all the companion plants and stuff. It's not about weed. It's about produce, including weed. There's tons of veggies and stuff for sale.
Veggies over headies.
Right.
Every time.
I know people dig veggies. Veggies are having a comeback, bro.
Well, no one's going to be buying weed in Armageddon.
Yeah. No. Well, no.
When rapture happens, no one's going to give a shit about it.
They'll
weed.
Be vaping.
You know?
They'll be vaporizing.
There you go.
Yeah.
And also, you list for that gram, we can't all wait 6 months. When I want to smoke a gram, I want to smoke a gram.
No,
I'm going to put the seed in and I can wait 6 months.
It's a culture. We live in a society of instant gratification.
Too true, eh?
I love it.
So let's talk about tax.
Let's talk about tax.
Because that's what everyone's been saying.
You and me.
Everyone's been saying legalize and regulate so you can tax it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Look what a great idea it's going to be to tax it. And then the taxes come and everyone's like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Who's the tax going to currently? Currently those taxes would be going to a corrupt...
No, we got to get
some... Well, where does your income tax go in any country?
Right.
You have to appeal to some kind of faith basis.
That's true.
Got nothing to do with the normative, but the meta. In theory, it should be used in such a way.
Yeah.
Whether it is or not is a different story. The point is the law can't, you know, the law can't be a like individual case by case.
What if you called it something else like payback to community because it's all one love and like weed is meant to save the world and we're doing this for the better good. So
right.
Instead of calling it tax, calling it
Ubuntu
payback or something.
Or in what do they have in BEE, like social empowerment or something?
Certainly, right.
And they have CSR and all kinds of
you
things like that.
Well,
but realistically, guys, at the end of the day, let's say it's all said and done. Let's say in a couple of months' time, the courts or whatever the government says, guys, it's legal and there's going to be rules in that. But there's no way around it. There will be tax. The thing is, there can be gang tax and keep it in the black market, or tax can be just like pretty low, like just that, and then it's a lot more accessible for people to get into it.
Good point.
So the question is, how much should legal weed? I'm not saying medicine, I'm not saying hemp, I'm saying weed. I'm saying all your oaks who want to get high as a mofo. How much tax should I be paying on that 200 a gram, or that 50 a gram, or that 10 rand a gram? You know, I know there's an informal market. Should it be tax-free? I don't know. Should it be the same as everything else, 14%? Or should it be like booze and ciggies? Because that's the only thing I can think of from the hip that's kind of close.
Yeah, no, there's all those trains of thought. It says treat it like wine or treat it like alcohol. But we never use that as an argument because it's nothing like wine or alcohol. You can't.
What do you mean? That's
advice. I mean, what the fuck do you mean? You mean
18
years of age... But there's more complexity to...
Like what?
Well, it's a fucking teacher plant. You don't go at the same place every time like you do when you're pissed. It does nothing
for
your condition. No, in general.
Because remember, the other side of the argument is it's a versatile. Everyone's got a different endocannabinoid system and responds differently to the entourage effect.
We were talking about how many hits you got off cannabinoids on breast milk before the show, remember?
Yeah.
And we got onto big glops of double Fs. We had like 38 double F cannabinoids at one stage.
Yeah.
It seems like a long time ago.
Yeah, dude. So realistically though, you know, again, Al I think brings up a valid point. I know we're not saying that it is the equivalent of booze or alcohol.
Why not?
But
why? But
I'm getting there is that it should be. Why not? Is it if I use it, and Oates hated when I say that as an intoxicant or whatever, if I'm using it to get high, maybe I should pay 40% tax.
All drugs have effects. All drugs
it's
have effects.
It's mind-altering, so yeah.
Well, not even that. It doesn't even have to be mind-altering. Take ibuprofen, and it has X, Y, Z effects.
It's kidney altering.
But ibuprofen doesn't have syntax.
It doesn't matter. Oh, it definitely does, bro. You know what it takes to get ibuprofen to get to the market. Way more than the money we're talking here. Big pharma, billions. $2 billion to get drug to market is roughly what they say.
No, except for sure,
CBD.
But now we're talking about... Like,
what do you mean except CBD?
Oh, they could fast track that.
No.
And
no,
they don't have to do a single test on a human to get it on the shelf.
That's where you're wrong. You have never read any of GW's clinical trials then.
Oh, no, we did. They've got the monopoly on them.
They've got phase 3 clinical trials in THCV.
In England.
In England and America.
Yeah. Yeah.
They have real people using THCV in a controlled placebo study.
I bet you they aren't paying as much tax as they should.
Probably not.
Motherfuckers, they'll be fucking.
Apparently, one of the husbands is some MP or there's some kind of politics.
They're just legal drug dealers. They're the only legal drug dealers.
You see what I'm saying?
So
they're just legal drug dealers.
Because Jay's saying tax free, 425 tax free. It's natural.
Well, like 4.2% tax would be cool.
14%.
How much was the percent on that sale? It was 7.21. 30%.
I say put VAT on it.
That sale that was shared on Instagram, Facebook, where that guy shared that slip. There was 3 grams, and each gram was 70 bucks, and the tax worked out to 70 bucks. So it was 30% on the fucking bill.
Yeah, that was Illinois.
And because of the higher THC.
And it broke down into different.
Actually,
we still have it. Let me just get it so we can read exactly what they were saying in it. That's fine.
You say syntax.
It already exists.
Yeah.
It's an infrastructure that's in place. We don't have to then worry so much about the medical claims and whether or not you can use pesticides. No, it's a vice. It's something that you can indulge in. Whether or not I drink beer because I think it makes me a better person, or I use Ibogaine, or I use cocaine, or whatever that point is if you can tax it the same way it is everywhere, you can then start to regulate it correctly. So if you want to have real medical application, it needs to go through real medical application.
Right.
If you just want to smoke it or drink it or brew your own beer or whatever, go for it. It's on you.
Yep.
It's
yeah.
your problem. It's called syntax. If you want to smoke cigarettes, your cancer. I'll cough. I'll die.
I think it's totally fucking insidious.
So?
The way it is. No,
the way the world works.
That's the way the syntax thing works, because it's a moral judgment.
Yeah.
Because who the fuck are you to call it a vice?
Maybe
it's a fucking habit. But it's not a vice is a dark fucking
thing.
A habit is just everyone's habitual. Fucking everyone eats lint. Everybody eats
but it's mind altering, right? And it's mind altering.
Lint.
Fucking
lint is mind altering. Oh,
so here's the tax that they put on it. So the subtotal of the sale was $2.20. Then they add on $1.65 for local county tax, $6.60 for local city tax, $19.25 for IL sales tax, $55 for IL rec excise, which means it's THC greater than 35%.
So it's concentrates.
Concentrates. It was, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was concentrates.
Shatter, and bud. Yes, there was. So they obviously okay. And then total tax $82.
So that sounds something like municipal tax, provincial tax, and VAT.
There we go.
But like total tax, $82 of how much?
And then $220. Yes, and then syntax.
Oh,
right?
So like
the sale was $220. Was
but
three, yeah.
I think the most important thing about just letting it, and whether or not you just let it or you believe it should go, I don't really care about that. But if you give it to that kind of infrastructure that already exists, watch how quickly things start to change. You know, if it becomes an SAB controlled thing, yeah, sure, we all hate corporate and I'm not debating the evils of the world, we all know it's out there, but rather, do you want to see weed in your local shop tomorrow? Let SAB take over. You know, let them say, cool, you can brew beer in your garage, but you can't brew spirits. You can grow weed in your garden, but you can't make concentrates. That's what Cali does.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, and then you'll see movement so quickly, because we don't have to worry about pesticides and cigarettes, perfect example. All the pesticides and crap that they add to it, that's the danger to it. But they say to you on the box, it's your problem. It's your problem.
Well,
deal with it.
Yeah, right.
Full disclosure.
Right? Yeah.